And I'm back now with Neil MacGregor. I want to ask you about another object. It's the double-headed serpent from Mexico. Tell me about that one.
This is one of the most extraordinary things in the British Museum, really. It was made in Mexico somewhere around 1500, just before the Spaniards arrive. And it's probably was meant to be worn around your neck. So it's a
around
big
your
necklace.
Neck.
It's like a big necklace. Uh-huh. But what you're looking at, of course, is one serpent with two heads made up of tiny pieces of turquoise. There are over 2,000 pieces of turquoise there. And it's a serpent which, if the light plays over it, the different pieces of turquoise look like feathers. So it's the Mexican god, the serpent, the feathered serpent. Mm-hmm. And what is really interesting about this, I think, is that it tells you, if you look at the object, a great deal about the Aztec Empire, because we now know that the different pieces of turquoise came from turquoise mines that were thousands of miles apart.
Oh, so it tells you about the size, the scope
of the empire.
Yeah.
And the fact that you couldn't have an object like this without an empire that can command the tribute mm-hmm. of the different places. Mm-hmm. And huge amounts of control over people, because the red shell, that beautiful red of the gums of the snake, is in fact thorny oyster, which you find in the Gulf of Mexico, but very deep. And it's extremely difficult and dangerous to gather. So you're looking at something which is hugely expensive, demands control of a huge area of territory and of people. In fact, it's the empire that was set up by the Aztecs to pay this tribute under force. And that, of course, is what the people hated, which is why when the Spaniards arrived, it could fall apart. So
that's how the story continues there,
yeah.
Right?
So looking at the object actually tells you how the empire functioned mm-hmm. and why it fell. And the last fascinating thing about it, which we can't know by looking at it, but from the Spanish side, we know that when Moctezuma met Cortes, he gave him a double-headed serpent.
Ah.
So this may be the very one.
Let me ask you, book aside, I'm just curious about your life and work at a place like the British Museum, one of the world's great encyclopedic museums. What's the biggest challenge of directing a place like that?
The biggest challenge is actually presenting the material in a way that the visitor finds it easy to engage with.
Uh-huh. So it's not overwhelming, it's not...
So it's just not overwhelming.
Yeah.
I mean, there are about 8 million objects. So the biggest challenge is actually which ones you're going to put on show. Uh-huh. The rest are there for study.
Yeah.
And then how you present what information you give. So that the visitor... What's special about the British Museum is that from the 1750s, it's tried to put the whole world into one building. Mm-hmm. And the idea has always been that you should be able to walk around the world. So the big challenge is to try to construct a walk that will take you through time and around the world.
And the biggest pleasure, besides getting to make that walk by yourself anytime you want?
That is the biggest pleasure.
It is?
The biggest pleasure is walking around the museum early in the morning when there's nobody there, and particularly standing in front of something like the ancient Egyptian statues. If you stand in front of the statue of the great pharaoh Ramesses II, you begin to feel that maybe your own budget worries are less important than you thought they were. It puts daily life into perspective.
I see.
I recommend it to everybody.
All right. Neil MacGregor is director of the British Museum. Thanks so much.
Thank you very much.